Hey, beautiful ladies of my heart. Are you ready to get a pouty lip without looking like a clown? I'm going to show you how to do that. I tell you, it's a game changer. I have such tiny lips, I could use all the help I could get. So this section is actually pulled out of a video that's coming out next Wednesday that was way too long, and it deserves its own place anyway. This is a very fun technique. It will take practice, but you will love it. So without further do-wack-a-do, let's get to it. First, for the lip, I am going to take this little concert, the Wonder Stick, and I am going to go around my lips. So if you go like this, see that right there? That's your muscle line. Your true lip line is above that. So the idea is to not be a clown. So what I do is I'm going to take that, and you can use any concealer, but I'm going to take this one by the Wonder Stick, the matte side, in light, and I'm going to draw right where my outer muscle line, and it's the same up here. This is just what I'm doing. They don't show you doing it that much, but I'm doing it because it has worked for me. Then I blend it in. Okay, so it looks really white. I'm not sure about that one, but I'm using it. And then I'm going to take my lip pencil. I'm using Soar by MAC. And I'm going to do my lip line, which means right below. You can still see it, and that's okay because we're going to blend it. But I want and I was told you not to stretch them because then it'll make it look bumpy. So it's difficult to learn how to put this on with your lips just natural. Okay. And then I fill in, and I go right under. So that is where I did here. So when I put that around, that's on my muscle lip line, the second one, I guess that's called. And then for the pout, you actually go on the muscle, and you bring this side down to fill it in so you don't have a clownish pout. That's a little bit too much of a pout there, but I'm talking so I can... And you have to do cleanup. Okay. It'll just come down to meet it. All right, have your lips natural. Supposed to go all the way in here. Okay, so then I need something. I'm going to take this little smudge brush. Yeah, I think concealer would have been a lot better for around that, but do you see what I was talking about? Now I have a pout, but it's not a clown pout. Now, when we were at Sephora, my granddaughters took me to Glossier. I've never used any Glossier, but I fell in love with these lip pens. And this one is in Ember, and they last. I mean, when you wipe your mouth and eat, it's not like a lip stain. I did order a lip stain. I'll let you know who I ordered it from. The lip stains that turn your lips look blue, and then you wipe it off, and you have, hopefully it's a mauve that I got. Okay, I like the lips. I've just been really tickled, and you want to get yourself a really good lip liner, and why I say that is because some of them drag and pull. This is like cream. It goes on and it stays. I just clean up. There you go. Isn't that pretty? Okay, beautiful ladies of my heart, here I am all finished, got the pout. Very simple, just three products. You can use concealer instead if you like. I just like that it had a little pencil on it. I think I'm going to go for a darker color because it really was hard to get it from not being so white down there. My MAC lip liner and my Glossier, whatever you want to use. Now, throughout the day, my lips wore really well. I had, you know, I do this a lot, and this is not when I edit, and I do hit that bottom lip line, but I keep my pencil with me along with my lipstick so I can touch up if needed. I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you learned something. Next Wednesday will be the rest of the video of my things I'm loving now with some surprises of what I'm not loving. Okay, don't miss it. I love you guys so much. Stay wild and crazy. Be good to yourself. Be kind. Don't step in anything squishy. Lala is out.